at 31. Welcome to example 5. We're going to take a look at Pascal's triangle. So Pascal's triangle is an array of the binomial coefficients. Each number in the triangle is the sum of the two numbers directly above it, one to the right and one to the left. So Pascal's triangle is this cool number pattern that shows up in math. It's named after this French mathematician from the 1800s, Blaise Pascal. Although it's unfortunate he gets the credit for it because there are many mathematicians that figured out this number pattern well before he did. There was a Persian mathematician, Al-Khwarizmi, in the late 900s, early 1000s that figured it out. There was a Chinese mathematician in the 13th century, Yang Hui, who figured it out, but Blaise got the credit for it. So, all right, Blaise got the credit. Let's go ahead and take a look at how this works out. Now, again, it's a triangular array of the binomial coefficients. And we've been looking at binomial coefficients through the lens of the binomial theorem when we sit there and try and expand a binomial. So Blaise figured out, or really I would say Al-Khwarizmi figured out, that you could make this triangular array of ones. I want you to take note that this looks like a triangle, right? All three of these graphics look like a triangle. And you can have ones on the outsides here. And then I'm going to explain how you get the numbers that aren't ones. We're going to talk about how each number in the triangle is the sum of the two numbers directly above it, one to the right, one to the left. But I want you to start to look at the pattern in the number and see if you can hear something familiar. So if I look at this third row, right, 1, 2, 1, right, 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. So I hope, especially for these two levels, the numbers sound familiar. We've seen these patterns before, especially 1331 and 14641, when we were expanding binomials raised to the third power or binomials raised to the fourth power. So what this triangle does is if you start at the n equaling zero level, so you think about expanding a binomial, x plus y to the n. All right, well, when n equals zero, right, anything raised to the zero is just one. When n equals 1, these will be the coefficients of your binomial expansion, right? This will then be the n equals 2 level. Then we'll have n equaling 3. Then n equaling 4. Then n equaling 5. So if you had x plus y raised to the 5th power, the coefficients of your terms are 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. If you had x plus y raised to the 4th power, the binomial coefficients would be 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. If something was cubed, 1, 3, 3, 1. And I showed you that in this graphic of the triangle, showing you that at the n equals 0 level, you're really looking at 0, choose 0. At the n equals 1, this is 1, choose 0, 1, choose 1. At the n equals 2, this is 2, choose 0, 2, choose 1, 2, choose 2. And these coefficients are the binomial coefficients that we've used in the binomial theorem. And they're fine, you can calculate that on your calculator, but it's cooler and faster to use Pascal's triangle. So let me show you how this sentence plays out. Again, each number in the triangle is the sum of the two numbers directly above it, one to the right and one to the left. All right, I want you to think about the number 2, right? If I go 1 to the left and 1 to the right and I add those, 1 plus 1 is 2. All right, let's think about the number 3 here. If I go above it, 1 to the left, 1 to the right, 1 plus 2 is 3. Right here, 2 plus 1 is 3, all right? And then if I want to build, right, you add another set of 1s on the outside, okay? So I'm adding another set of 1s. Let's try this now. 1 plus 3 is 4. 3 plus 3 is 6. 3 plus 1 is 4, right? Add another set of 1s. Here we go. 1 plus 4 is 5. 4 plus 6 is 10. 6 plus 4 is 10. 4 plus 1 is 5. So you can keep on building this triangular array, this pattern, by expanding and adding ones on the next side. And let me just do this. Let me do the n equals 6 level so you could see me calculate it. I would put some ones on the outside and we would go 1 plus 5 is 6, 5 plus 10 is 15, then we got 20, 15, and 6. So if I had a binomial raised to the 6th power, I know that the coefficients are 1, 6, 15, 20, 15, 6, 1. And yes, there's symmetry in that. There's been symmetry every time we've used the binomial theorem. And it's just that doing this is a lot faster than doing 6 choose 0 on my calculator and then 6 choose 1, 6 choose 2, 6 choose 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is just faster. It makes the process more efficient, so I'm gonna use it. All right, this last graphic, this triangular expansion, is taking a look at x plus 1, specifically raised to the nth power, right? This is raised to the 0 power, first power, squared, cubed, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, so on and so forth. All right, so we're gonna use Pascal's triangle in combo with the binomial theorem, and we're gonna expand this binomial, and I'm just gonna try and get as efficient as possible. So here we go. Let's take a look at how we expand this binomial. All right, let me scooch this up. So I'm looking at r plus 2s to the fourth. So let me build my triangle. And I know it's just up here, but I want to show you how to build it. So I start with the triangle of ones. All right, this is again, n equals 0, n equals 1. I need to get to the fourth level because I have a degree 4 binomial. So I will add ones on the outside. This is building the n equals 2 level. And then I need the 2 here. Let me add some more ones. We gotta go to n equals 3. All right, this is 3, 3. And then I gotta go one level more because I gotta get to the n equals 4th level. So 1, 1. All right, here we go. 4, 6, 4. Okay, so I've built my triangle. These are going to be the coefficients of my binomial expansion. And then if you remember, we're going to start with r to the fourth, decrease the power of r. We're gonna start with 2s to the zero and increase the power of 2s. So here is my expansion. My first coefficient is 1, then it will be r to the fourth power, and then 2s to the zero power, all right? The next coefficient will be a 4, and then I'm gonna decrease the power on r and increase the power on 2s. My next coefficient will be a 6, and then I'm going to, let's see, where were we? R cubed, so I gotta go r squared, and then 2s squared. All right, I'm gonna keep on going. I'm gonna head to the next line because this is over here. Let me put this in its own little bubble. So here's the Pascal's triangle work. All right, so our next coefficient is a 4. And then I'm gonna go r to the first power, and then we gotta bump up the power on 2s. And last but not least, my coefficient is 1. And then I've got to, here we go, take the power on r down and bump the power up on 2s. Now before I simplify, I'm just gonna do a quick check. Do all of the exponents add to 4? So 4 plus 0 is 4, 3 plus 1, 4, 2, 2, 1, 3, 0, 4. I just do a quick little check. There's times when I mess up the powers, so it's not a bad idea to just have a safety net there. All right, now it's time to clean this up. All right, r to the fourth, great, is r to the fourth. Times one, still r to the fourth. Anything to the zero is one. So this first term is just r to the fourth. All right, plus, all right, 2s to the first is 2s. So 4 times 2 is 8. And then I'm gonna have r cubed s. All right, plus, all right, 2 squared is going to be 4. 4 times 6 is going to be 24. I'm going to have r squared, s squared. All right. 2 cubed is 8. 8 times 4 is 32. And then I have r s cubed. 2 to the 4th is 16. So I'm just going to have 16. Oops, excuse me. I'm not going to have 16 r to the 4th. I'm going to have 16 s to the 4th. All right, and then let's just do a quick check. Did the powers of r descend? 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Great. Did the powers of s ascend? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have just a couple of quick little checks, making sure that my powers match the way they should. And there's my binomial expansion. So I did all of this, no calculator, no running any factorials for the binomial coefficients. I just used Pascal's triangle in combination with the binomial theorem, and I expanded this binomial. All right, so we're gonna flip the page and we're gonna expand two more binomials that are a lot uglier. All right, so we're gonna make this look that much worse, but we're still using Pascal's triangle and the binomial theorem. All right, I'll see you in a few, gang. Bye.